In just a few months, one of the most ambitious infrastructure projects in North America will open to the public. A bridge so massive it stretches nearly a mile across the Detroit River. A $4.7 billion engineering feat, built with millimeter precision. And a structure that promises to completely reshape the busiest commercial border crossing on the continent. This is the final year of the Gordie Howe International Bridge, a project 2 decades in the making. If you've ever driven between Detroit, Michigan, and Windsor, Ontario, you know the journey isn't exactly smooth. For almost a century, the main connection between the two cities has been the Ambassador Bridge, built in 1929. At the time, it was a marvel, the longest suspension bridge in the world. But it was designed for the traffic of the 1920s, not the more than 40,000 vehicles that cross the border every day in the 21st century. The Canadian side of the Ambassador Bridge has another problem. It doesn't connect directly to a highway. Trucks are forced to crawl through local streets before reaching Highway 401, Canada's busiest roadway. This creates delays, pollution, and safety hazards in residential neighborhoods. For decades, business leaders, truckers, and politicians have been calling for a modern, direct highway link between Canada and the U.S. in Detroit. Talks for a new crossing started in the early 2000s. In 2004, Canada and the U.S. signed an agreement to explore the project. It wasn't a quick process. It took 8 more years before the Windsor-Detroit Bridge Authority, WDBA, was created in 2012 to actually make it happen. In 2018, construction officially began. And here's an interesting twist. Although the bridge will connect 2 countries, Canada is paying for the entire project, not just the bridge itself, but also the U.S. Customs Plaza and access roads. The reason? Canada saw the long-term trade benefits as worth the investment. Funding is coming through a public-private partnership, meaning private contractors design, build, and maintain the bridge for 30 years, while Canada foots the bill. When complete, the Gordie Howe International Bridge will be 2.5 kilometers, 1.5 miles long from end to end. The main span across the river measures 853 meters, 2,800 feet, making it the longest main span of any cable-stayed bridge in North America. The 2 main support towers rise 220 meters, 720 feet, taller than the tallest building in Detroit. Each tower was built using self-climbing cranes that moved up as construction progressed, a method that kept crews safe and work moving efficiently. The bridge is supported by 216 steel cables, each tensioned to exact specifications to hold roughly 34 million pounds of weight. On the Canadian side, the bridge will link directly to Highway 401. On the U.S. side, it will connect straight into Interstate 75, thanks to a massive new interchange. This interchange isn't just for vehicles. It includes 5 pedestrian bridges, upgraded cycling paths, and landscaped areas designed to reconnect neighborhoods divided by the highway decades ago. Large projects rarely go exactly as planned, and this one was no exception. When construction started, the budget was about $2.8 billion, with an expected opening in 2024. Then came the COVID-19 pandemic. Work slowed, supply chains broke down, and border restrictions made moving people and equipment more difficult. The opening date was pushed to fall 2025, and the cost grew to $4.7 billion. Another challenge was working over the busy Detroit River, one of the most important shipping routes in North America. Construction crews had to coordinate with shipping schedules and ensure safety for both workers and passing vessels. Perhaps the most impressive achievement came in June 2024, when the 2 halves of the main span met in the middle. Engineers managed to align them with just 10 millimeters of error, about the thickness of a pencil. This bridge isn't just about moving trucks and cars. It includes a toll-free multi-use path for pedestrians and cyclists, linking Canada's Great Lakes Waterfront Trail with the Iron Bell Trail in Michigan. For the first time, cyclists will be able to ride across the Detroit River without using a tunnel or car ferry. At both ends of the bridge, massive ports of entry are nearing completion. These are more than just toll booths. They're high-tech inspection facilities with advanced security systems, digital tolling that accepts multiple payment methods and currencies, and enough lanes to keep traffic flowing smoothly. The Canadian port covers about 53 hectares, while the U.S. port is around 68 hectares, making them some of the largest border inspection plazas in the world. It's easy to focus on steel, cables, and concrete, but the real story here is the people who built it. Over the course of the project, more than 2,500 workers have contributed, logging over 13 million labor hours. Crews have worked through blistering heat, freezing winters, and even during a global pandemic to keep the project moving forward. Specialist teams from around the world, including Canada, the US, Europe, and Asia, came together to handle complex tasks like cable installation, tower crane operations, and precision surveying. As of mid-2025, the Gordie Howe International Bridge is about 95% complete. All major structural work is done, the tower cranes are gone, and crews are now focused on finishing touches, paving, lighting, signage, and system testing. 2025 is the year for systems integration, linking together everything from traffic cameras to fire suppression systems, lighting controls, and communication networks. These systems will be tested repeatedly to ensure everything works perfectly from day one. The official substantial completion date is set for September 2025, with an opening in the fall of 2025. When it does open, it's expected to handle thousands of vehicles per hour and dramatically reduce wait times at the border. For Canada and the United States, the Gordie Howe International Bridge is more than just steel and concrete. It's a new economic artery. The Detroit-Windsor crossing already sees over $100 billion in goods move across each year. By making the connection faster and more reliable, the bridge is expected to boost trade, create jobs, and improve supply chain resilience. For local communities, it means less traffic congestion, safer streets, and new opportunities for walking and cycling between two countries. And for engineers, it stands as a new icon of North American bridge design, combining world-class engineering with modern technology and community-focused planning. It took more than 20 years of planning, 7 years of construction, and billions of dollars to bring the Gordie Howe International Bridge to life. But when those first cars and trucks roll across later this year, it will mark the start of a new chapter, one where Detroit and Windsor are more connected than ever, and where two countries share the benefits of one bold vision. In the words of its namesake, hockey legend Gordie Howe, "You've got to love what you're doing. If you love it, you can overcome anything." For the teams who built this bridge, that's exactly what they did. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, hit subscribe to USA Mega Projects for more incredible stories of America's biggest builds.